Rick Hong here for Hollywood First Look Features. Tonight, we're at the red carpet premiere for The Last Full Measure. The movie stars Sebastian Stan, Diane Ladd, Bradley Whitford, and Samuel L. Jackson. Let's take a first look.
The Medal of Honor is the highest recognition of military valor there is. You'll prepare a full decorations review.
Mr. Pitsenbarger, sir.
I'm from the Department of Defense.
I'm here to learn about
your son.
If you want the real story, you'll need to talk to the mud soldiers.
I've never seen lost men like that. Pitsenbarger comes down that wire and saves men he never even knew.
Sounds like a suicide mission.
Suicide is hopeless. What Pitsenbarger did was valor.
I kept telling him to get out, but he wouldn't go.
He was there to save lives, and that's what he was doing.
Why are you here?
Because you're here.
Hell, he shouldn't even have been there. None of us should.
What are you saying?
That's friendly fire. We were fighting our own men.
The after-action report is missing. Who even thought up Operation Abilene in the first place?
It's not a can of worms you want to open.
Why not?
Information was removed from the original review.
You had no idea where you're starting.
I have never seen you back off of anything.
Usually we're judged by what we do. But what we don't do is what haunts us.
I'm gonna go public with the story.
Sounds a little dangerous.
But it'll be great television.
I was wondering, so how did William Pitsenbarger's like story come to you? And then for you to say, like, I'm gonna try to go get the rights, I wanna direct this. Write and direct it.
Yeah, I had been doing research on another project, and I had the opportunity to meet a lot of young airmen who were training to be pararescue jumpers, and they all wanted me to know the story of their sort of archangel, William Pitsenbarger. And then I had the opportunity to meet his dad, his father, who spoke some of the lines that are actually in the film. The lines where he says, I never got to see my son marry and have a child of his own because only then could he understand how much his father loved him. And when I heard those words, I just saw the movie. I just knew that it was a story about family, generational love between men. And so I was on my way.
When you get the script, do you go and research about William Pitsenbarger yourself? Or do you just kind of stick to the script and what your character does?
I mean, when I read the script, it was kind of like, wow, how come I've never heard of this story? So I did do the online research. I watched as much as I could of documentaries about that era and that time. And most importantly for me is I went and spoke to the man that I play in the movie, Secretary Peters, who was the one who campaigned to get him the Medal of Honor and help the Mud Soldiers honor, you know, the man who'd saved their lives. So that's what I did. And when you've got someone as wonderful as Whit Peters to model yourself on, you don't have to do too much acting. I just kind of had to, you know, serve the story.
You're playing the mother of William Pitsenbarger, and I don't know if she's still alive or if you had a chance to talk with her. Yeah, I wanted to know about, like, kind of your research for this, for playing her.
I did not get to meet her, but I met all the people, especially the veterans, who knew her. And the one thing they said to me was, we think you did a great job portraying her, and we thank you for it. And it just broke my heart and touched me so much, because it's a true story about all our lives, how we fight for what's right. And you gotta fight for what's right. And it's about greed and corruption and the games that we all run into, whether it's paying the light bill or the water bill or whatever. It's life. And you have to keep the joy and the truth in you and fight for it. And this is one of those movies that inspires you to do that.
This is a new experience for our culture. The devotion of men and women going into the service for their country and afterwards needing help from their country, meaning us. And people, when they get that, they actually, when they extend themselves a little bit to understand that, they realize they're the ones that need more too. You know, we have the same effect on our lives today that they are going through with PTS, post-traumatic stress, first responders. And they're doing that. They're coming, groups SAW, Save a Warrior, all of those people are working together. Mission 22, it's exciting. So this film brings that to me now. And I I was grateful I was a part of it.
When you get the script, you know, you read it, I was wondering, do you go and start researching about William Pitsenbarger, because this is his story, before you go to set?
Yeah, you try to read everything you possibly can. And then, you know, talk to the director and the writer, you know, Todd. And
same guy, yeah.
Same guy. I was part of a film called Jarhead for a little bit. And one of the things that, you know, when I sat down and I met with Sam Mendes, it was like, yeah, don't read the book. We're going off the script. And you're like, oh. Kind of push the book aside. That wasn't really Todd for me. Todd goes, hey, dive into everything you can, read everything you can, understand what this man did, understand what the men around him did, and get in there and do the best job you possibly can in the circumstances. So to answer your question, yeah, you do everything you can to make sure you don't miss anything. You want attention to detail, so it's important.
I watch this movie. You're great in this, like you are in everything. You've walked, you know, many... you know, episodes of The West Wing. So I was wondering, like, playing this character, if you're kind of like, oh yeah, I'm a little at ease. I know how to play like a government politician guy.
Yeah. A smart guy in a suit, or a guy who thinks he's smart in a suit, but really has some terrible ethical flaw. Yeah. yeah, this was fun. I mean, the thing that got me into this movie was Todd Robinson, our director's just in... It cannot be said enough how persistent he was in getting this movie made. Very hard to get a movie made independently, almost impossible. And with this extraordinary cast, it's a real testament to him. I'm proud of him.
The movie's in theaters January 24th. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, I'm Rick Collins.
Getting that medal for Pitts, for the men I lost, might be the only decent thing I pull out of that war.
Pitsenbarger's father. He's dying.
Dying isn't harder than losing a child. Do what you can.
Guys like Pitsenbarger do what they do for each other. Life for a life.
I need to finish this.
Give praise as this young man ensures that the sacrifices of the fallen will never be forgotten.